Hi, I'm Josh Ellsworth, General Manager with Stahls CAD Cut Direct. A few years back, we did a video all about footwear customization. We gave you some tips and tricks and showed you how to decorate multiple pairs of shoes. Well, since then, we've managed to implement a lot of different systems and have customers customizing shoes every day. Throughout this course of time, we've learned a lot, and we want to show you our latest system for customizing shoes utilizing the Hotronix heat press and Stahls CAD Cut Fashion Film Heat Transfer Film. So it all starts with the heat press. At Hotronix, we've developed what's called a shoe platen. And it starts with the Hotronix press. Here I'm working with the Air Fusion, but the Hotronix Air Fusion, the Hotronix Fusion, and the AutoClam and Max series all feature interchangeable platens. You simply click out for this particular style and take off the 16 by 20 platen. And at Stahls, we now sell a shoe platen specifically for footwear. It comes with the pin registration system for the Air Fusion and the Fusion. You just drop that into place and lock it back in on your press. Now, it's very easy to load a pair of shoes and print at one time. We're going to show you how to do that momentarily. This particular platen also comes with the pad attached to it, which allows it to accommodate a wide variety of shoes and also prevents the shoes from falling off. This is something we've learned over the course of time. Now you need a way to create graphics to apply to those shoes. For this you have a couple options. One, if you want a full color logo, we can create a digital transfer called CAD prints. All you need to do is visit stahls.com and upload your art. But if you have a vinyl cutter, you can actually order heat transfer film from us that we manufacture and sell direct. It's called CAD Cut Fashion Film. So you can load that into a vinyl cutter and cut designs specifically for application to shoes. And we'll show you how to do that. I have a scrap piece of fashion film here. This is a great way to utilize scraps since shoe logos are typically very small. I'm just going to load it into my cutter. In this case, I'm utilizing the Roland GX24. We can also place you with a vinyl cutter at Stahls capable of cutting these graphics. I'm going to tell the machine a piece is loaded, and it's simply going to measure the width and the length of the piece so I know how much scrap material I'm working with. I'll verify that my force is correct, my cutting down force on the cutter, and then I'll send the job. I've already created a design in the design software, cadworkslive.com. Once the cutting is completed, I'll remove the piece and we'll complete the weeding process. Utilizing the Stahls Easy Weeder, we will start at the weed border by picking away the excess material and just grabbing and pulling. Now this is another key reason we use fashion film. There's some reasons in the heat application process, but the high sticky backing allows you to accommodate a lot of detail. And that's important when doing small footwear graphics. Trim out my design, being careful to save as much material as possible because it can be used to cut another shoe graphic down the line. Doesn't take much material to do this. Let's show you how to heat apply this. The fashion film has a sticky backing on the material, so it is able to actually hold to the shoe. Otherwise you could use thermal tape, which would help you keep it into position. But in this case it's able to just stick down and apply. And now something people are most apprehensive about naturally is melting the shoe. They don't understand that you can actually heat press footwear. This is why we now recommend the flexible application pad, which is just a cover sheet, a siliconized cover sheet that you can use to cover the entire surface of the shoe prior to pressing. Swing the heat press back into place. And for fashion film, we recommend 320 degrees, a medium pressure, in 30 seconds. Normally fashion film is a 15 to 20 second application, but I need 30 seconds because I've added the flexible application pad as a barrier in between. Once the application completes, simply remove the flexible application pad and fashion film backing can be peeled away. We have a completed pair of shoes. It's important to note that the cost of this material is only about a penny a square inch, so it's about a nickel for each graphic on each shoe, so it can be very profitable. Now let's go through the application of a wide variety of shoes, and the next pair we'll do is another pair of cleats, this time for football. And we've cut out a fashion film electric material, the QB number 7 design, just showing you a concept if you wanted to incorporate a player's position as well as a number. In the last design, of course, we did the player name with the number. Just to repeat the steps, we load the shoe, position the material, cover everything with the flexible application pad, and then heat apply. There will be no preheating required when you're decorating footwear. Just press and peel. And that finished design is on there to stay. Now let's go with a pair of soccer cleats. One of the major markets for personalization of shoes is naturally sports and cleats because players want to show their number. In this case, we'll use a neon yellow color. Neon colors are prevalent in shoes, so it's a good product to put on the shelf when you first start customizing shoes. Neons, electrics, metallics, these are all good shades. Even though the shoe surface is a little more of a glossy surface and almost a plastic-like, you can still apply to it. Just always make sure you cover with the flexible application pad, press for one step and peel. We can't possibly predict the materials that construct every shoe on the market, so we'll give you some fair warning. We didn't ruin any shoes in this example, and we have plenty of customers doing it, but I'm still going to recommend that you test the footwear if possible before you start offering it as a stock offering. In this case, we'll switch gears and do a pair of sneakers and show you a tone-on-tone look using fashion film and a electric blue shade on top of the white area of the shoe as well as the royal blue area of the shoe. Two separate placements, and we'll apply it all together. We're showing you the variety of shoes just to give you ideas. A lot of customers have actually implemented shoe customization, allowing the customer to go to Finish Line or Foot Locker or whatever shoe store is available and actually bring the pair of shoes into your location. And customize one pair at a time can be profitable. Many sporting goods businesses are selling customization for $10 a pair. In a retail setting, I think you can command more than that. Once again, all with about 10 cents in material costs. Here we'll do a pair of kid shoes, bright and colorful, and we're matching up fashion film in a brighter shade of green here. It's actually the apple green color. This is probably about the smallest shoe that you can fit on the shoe platen. It doesn't necessarily fit baby or toddler shoes. This is just a kid size shoe. So you just want to make sure you can accommodate the shoes on the standard platen. We can always do custom cut platens specific to size, but this shoe platen will accommodate most kid shoes and certainly the teenager shoes and adult shoes. Both men's and women's styles. Now we'd like to show you a heel placement on an actual sandal. You can accommodate heel placements on the shoe platen. You just need to make sure it has a collapsible heel. Even if it's on a sneaker or cleat style, it needs to have a collapsible heel to be loaded on the press like this and apply accurate pressure. In this case, we've actually switched materials on you, and we're using the 3M Scotch-Lite Reflective. And you can see the backing isn't quite as sticky, which is presenting an issue. And so that's why we're going to grab the Stahls Thermal Tape, just to tape that design down into place to make sure it doesn't shift and move when we go to cover it and heat press it. But 3M Reflective is a very unique material to use on shoes, especially for this particular application, which is for a camp or where the kid or the counselor may be out hiking. Of course, you can do reflective on running shoes. There's a ton of different applications for reflective. But just press and peel. Using the same application settings as we mentioned before. And then we're just going to, we print it, and now we spin it to do a side placement, where we'll once again leverage fashion film in the color neon orange, and we cut the name of the camp to put on the side of the sandal. And we have a completed pair, this time with the two placements. And lastly, let's step it up and do some glittery shoes. And we've cut our Stahls CAD cut glitter flake material so it matches the sheen of the shoe. Glitter flake is a little more challenging to cut small detail on, so you want to limit exactly how small the detail, but for a basic text-based design like this, it's no problem. So we're positioning our pink color of glitter flake onto the bling shoes, once again following the same application. Peeling the backing after it's complete, and now we have a style of shoes that we could approach a number of demographics with. You can go and call on dance schools, cheer squads, just kids, girls in general. A very nice look. So as you're probably starting to see, there is a ton of opportunity for customizing footwear, and it can be very profitable. All you need to get started is a Hotronix heat press that allows you to interchange platens. Then you'll need the shoe platen for the Hotronix press. Now if you're working with a clam press, it would be beneficial to have the heat press caddy or the heat press counter caddy to raise it for loading the shoes. You also need the flexible application pad, and then of course you'll need a Stahls CAD cut direct heat transfer material. I recommend starting with the CAD cut fashion film or CAD cut fashion film electric, and then you can experiment more with 3M reflective and glitter flake as you saw in this video. Good luck in customizing footwear in your store, and thanks for watching.